Hey guys, welcome to yet another tutorial by MATLAB Helper. Today we'll be talking about frequency domain analysis in control systems. Frequency domain analysis is basically the study of how my signal's amplitude changes with different frequencies. While time domain analysis shows how a signal changes over time, frequency domain analysis shows how the signal's energy is distributed over a range of frequencies. Now, this is far more important because most of my applications require the use of my frequencies and how my energy is varying. Now, frequency domain analysis, it's very important and it finds applications in signal processing, areas of communications, geology, remote sensing, image processing, etc., etc. To start off with, we'd be defining our system whose frequency domain analysis we want to perform. We do that by the help of defining the transfer function command and enclosing our transfer function within it. If you need any help with transfer functions, you can refer to our previous tutorials. So here I have my system object, which defines my control system, which I want to analyze. For frequency domain analysis, we have a lot of tools, a lot of plots, quite similar to time domain. For example, we have the Bode plot, the Nyquist plot, the Nichols chart, the polar plot, the M and N circles. So we'd be starting off by one of the most simplest plots, that is the Bode plot. And in the parentheses, I'd be enclosing my transfer function object. So the Bode plot, basically, it gives me two plots. First is the magnitude response, and second is the phase response. Now, Bode plot is a logarithmic plot, first of all, and it gives me the magnitude of the sinusoidal transfer function and the phase angle in degrees, which is in omega. Now, Bode plots, they're used for stability studies of system with minimum phase loop transfer function. And they can easily help in frequency domain specifications calculation. Now, another very commonly used plot is my Nyquist plot. I plot my Nyquist diagram with the help of the command Nyquist plot. Now, as you can see, Nyquist plot, the Nyquist diagram, it's just a single plot with the x-axis as the real axis and the y-axis as the imaginary axis, and it gives me a closed loop diagram. Now, the position of the roots, whether they lie within the circle or outside of it, determines the stability of my control system. Therefore, I use the Nyquist plot in stability analysis, and it's of great use. Now, we'd be moving on to another plot, which is again very widely used, and it is called the Nichols plot. And the Nichols chart or the Nichols plot, whatever you call it, its command is again very simply Nichols plot, and it gives me a sort of open loop. And what it does is it displays me the locus of the log of the magnitude versus the argument of my transfer function. It's similar to the Bode plot in terms of the fact that it is again a logarithmic plot. You can determine that by the fact that the y-axis is in decibels, and decibels is a notation for logarithmic plots. And it is used in a lot of feedback control design and finds several applications. Now, again, similar to time domain specifications, we also have frequency domain specifications of a control system, and they help us in determining how my system behaves. So bandwidth is a frequency domain specification that tells me how wide the range of my signal is. Another very commonly used specification is the DC gain. Again, the DC gain tells me the gain of my system over a particular range. Next, I have my gain crossover frequency. Now, what I simply do is In my gain crossover, I do not just write the system in the parentheses. I have to follow this by the gain. So for example, my gain is 1. And then determine where is my frequency crossing my system at the given value of gain. So as you can see, if I just wrote the system, it showed an error. Another very commonly used frequency domain specification is the peak gain. It, as the name suggests, it tells me the highest value of the gain. Now, these were a few examples of frequency domain analysis specifications. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below. And don't forget to keep watching MATLAB Helper. Thank you.